This is a half-scale replica of the Tom Thumb locomotive. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution.
So first, who is Tom Thumb anyway? Well, Tom was originally a character from English folklore, although the earliest possible reference was from 1584. The earliest definitive reference was from 1621, with the History of Tom Thumb credited with being the first fairy tale ever printed in English. That's him sitting on the side of the bowl. Tom was small and powerful, and he had a lot of adventures. Over the centuries, he became quite popular in children's stories. Here you see him battling insects in a book from 1888. But back to railroads. In 1829, railroads weren't always run by steam locomotives. This was the same year as Rocket was built over in England for the Raintree trials. Go check out my video on that if you haven't seen it yet. But at this time, a lot of trains were actually pulled by the far more reliable, far cheaper, and far lower maintenance devices known as horses. They were still set on iron rails, which gave them more speed and more weight capacity per horse, but they really weren't as fast, and they couldn't handle the same loads as steam engines. Peter Cooper decided to change that. He built the original Tom Thumb steam locomotive strictly as a demonstration for the directors of the B&O Railroad. Here's a drawing believed to be the original Tom Thumb, although no one's sure how accurate it really is, or for that matter, if the artist ever actually saw the original in the first place. On August 28, 1830, Peter Cooper used Tom Thumb to take the B&O Railroad Board of Directors from Baltimore to Ellicott's Mill at a speed of 10 to 14 miles per hour. This trip was enough to convince the board that steam power was the future, and it secured funding for future steam development. The locomotive was only around for a few years, but it did pick up some good stories during that time. On August 28, 1830, or maybe it was August 25th, or, well, possibly September 28th, Tom Thumb was challenged to an impromptu race. With two parallel sets of tracks running for a length of 8 miles, the owners of Stockton and Company, the local competition for freight and passenger service, which utilized horse-drawn trains, challenged Tom Thumb. And, of course, Peter Cooper accepted. Tom Thumb started off strong and achieved an impressive lead, at least until the blower belt either broke or slipped off, depending on which version of the story you're listening to. With the blower no longer helping to pull air through the firebox, though, steam pressure quickly dropped and, well, the horses won. Well, the horses did win that day. Steam ran out in the long run. The B&O stopped using horses in 1831, just 2 years after the Tom Thumb locomotive was first built. Did this race ever actually happen? There's a lot of uncertainty, so it's really hard to say for sure, but I really hope so. It's a great story. The original Tom Thumb was really only intended as a demonstration, not for revenue service. And, as is so often the case with historic firsts, it wasn't really recognized at the time as even being historic, so it was simply scrapped in 1834. In 1927, though, B&O Railroad created a replica. They reproduced it as best they could, working from descriptions, a probable 1831 drawing of the original, and an 1892 wooden model made from descriptions. They ran the replica at the 1927 Fair of the Iron Horse, pulling passengers and showing the ingenuity of Peter Cooper. This video is from that event in 1927. You can see this replica today at the B&O Railroad Museum in Baltimore. Back here at the Hesston Steam Museum in Indiana, though, we can get a closer look at this half-scale replica. I arrived early, and they were still bringing the boiler up to pressure. Like all boilers, you want to heat them up and cool them down slowly to reduce metal stress and fatigue.
Just some brief sketches. So everything was mostly made off of that. I do know one of the differences, so...
While we wait, let's take a closer look. You can see the central vertical cylinder connected to the gearing system below. This connects directly to the drive axle. There's a few changes in this replica made for safety, such as the addition of brakes. and also the ill-fated blower belt, which on the original connected from the drive axle to the blower located in the stack, has been replaced with a more standard steam-powered blower. But otherwise, this is a pretty good replica. Of course, seeing a replica sitting here in front of you is great, but there is something better. So although this locomotive was never put into revenue service, it still led the way to steam train service in North America. And that's why this is the Industrial Revolution. Hey, before you go, I do need your help to keep this channel growing. Easiest thing you can do is just like or subscribe to the video. That tells YouTube, hey, this channel is worth watching. It'll show it to more people. Other thing you can do, completely free, is just leave a comment. More than two or three words is all it takes, and that counts as YouTube interaction. That's the strongest signal you can send to YouTube to recommend a channel to other people. Beyond that, if you can help out, this channel is actually fairly expensive to run. I usually drive 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours each way to get to these sites, so it can get pretty expensive. If you can help out with that, I have a Patreon page over at patreon.com/industrialrevolution. There's monthly memberships over there. Or if you're interested in just a one-time contribution to help out, just hit the super thanks button on this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you at the next one.